Hey guys, it's Michael from Fire and Brilliance, and today's episode is actually a very, very unique episode. And I know I say this every week, but today's episode is by popular request from our fans, our followers, our all of our subscribers on all of the different platforms, and also internally. If you may not know, and I know I've mentioned this a few times in the past, I'm actually the CEO of Fire and Brilliance, which we are also a company outside of the YouTube channel where we also do sell jewelry. And normally I don't talk about our own company because this specific channel here, the Geminar, is specifically for educational purposes. But today's episode, by popular request, I do want to basically do a shout out to my own company. So that said, about in around 2017, we launched our own Fab Moissanite line, okay? So for the longest time, there was a company that owned the market because they had a patent for over 20 years and no other company in the world could sell Moissanite. But since the patent expired, we actually decided to launch our own Moissanite brand. And this episode is to reintroduce all of the Fab Moissanite shapes and cuts and lines, because ever since we introduced it a couple of years ago, we have also provided and included more product options and stones and gemstones into that line. So this episode, again by popular request, is to go over, reintroduce the Fab Moissanite line. I'm gonna get right into it for you. All right, so before breaking down all of the different lines of Fab Moissanite, I want to let you know that we here at Fire and Brilliance have made many connections all around the world, here in the United States and across the globe, to work with many different manufacturers, many Moissanite dealers, and at the same time, the very important part that I want you to know is that we are working with very specific master cutters. Okay, so what does that mean? What a master diamond cutter with years of experience will do is that they have precision cutting. They know how to cut it based on experience and precision to maximize the sparkle, to maximize the light reflection, and to maximize the beauty and the quality of the gemstone. In order to be a master diamond cutter, you have to have years of experience. You have to know how to cut, polish a gemstone. And we worked with diamond cutters, colored gemstone cutters, Moissanite cutters. So if you can find these types of people, you want to keep them. And that's exactly what we did. We have networked with these people all across the globe to cut our Moissanite to ensure that we specifically increase the quality and obviously at the end of the day, increase the satisfaction and the longevity of the gemstone so that our Fab Moissanite can stand the test of time. All right guys, so we actually have many different lines of Moissanite, and you may question, what does that mean? Isn't a Moissanite a Moissanite? Well, yes, a Moissanite is a Moissanite. A Moissanite is made of silicon carbide. However, there are many different types of cuts and shapes. So let me go ahead and go over the different lines. Okay, so the first line I want to go over is what we call the traditional cuts. What are the traditional cuts? Well, these are the cuts that are actually very popular. These are the cuts that most people normally are looking for. These are the types of cuts that you can normally see when you go into a retail store, when you search online. These are the most popular cuts that people will wear. But even within the traditional cuts, there are many different shapes, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and break that down for you, okay? So in the traditional cuts, there is the round shape, and that is called a brilliant cut. What is a brilliant round cut? Well, in our line of Fire and Brilliance, our cuts is to maximize the fire and the brilliance of the round cut. Many people that are purchasing a round, brilliant, traditional cut, they're looking for a lot of sparkles. So if you are going the traditional route, if you love the round cut gemstone, if you love the symmetry of a round cut gemstone, then definitely check out the Fab Round Brilliant Cut Moissanite. Now, the second cut that I want to go over is an emerald cut. What is an emerald cut? If you're familiar with an asher cut, all it is an elongated asher. That is technically an emerald cut, but it's not a brilliant cut. It's called a step cut. What is a step cut? The way the gemstone is faceted, it looks as if there are symmetrical mirrors just lining up and looking at each other. Or if you're looking from the top view, looking down into the crown of the gemstone or the top of the gemstone, it looks as if there are stairways going up. So that is what a step cut is. It's actually parallel lines going from the sides of the gemstones, just cutting into the gemstone, giving it the illusion of steps or a step cut. Many people love the emerald cut because of the step cut, because of the classic look and the beautiful nature of how it is cut. Okay, so if you love elongated gemstones, if you love sharp corners, and if you are not into rounded corners, then you may want to look at the traditional fab emerald cut. Now the third cut is the oval cut. The oval cut, I would have to say, is probably one of the more popular cuts of all traditional cuts other than the round cuts, because for people that want a rounded gemstone but an elongated version of a rounded gemstone, they typically love the oval cuts. What is an oval cut? Well, it's actually rounded and curved on the top as well as the bottom, and it's typically a little rounded on the sides of the gemstone to get making an oval look and feel. That said, an oval shaped gemstone is also an elongated gemstone. And what is the benefit of an oval shaped gemstone? Sometimes an elongated gemstone may make the gemstone appear larger than the actual carat weight. So for example, you purchase a 1-carat round gemstone versus a 1-carat oval gemstone. Although the weight is the same, the oval gemstone may actually look bigger because it is elongated. And it's also a brilliant cut, which means it maximizes the fire and the brilliance and the sparkle of the gemstone. So if you like that type of cut, definitely check out the Fab traditional oval cut. All right, so the fourth cut that I want to go over is the traditional cushion cut. Now, I mentioned to you that the oval cut's quite popular, but I would say the close second to an oval cut after the round cut is a cushion cut. And for people that love cushions, you know what I'm talking about. It's actually soft on the edges and soft at the bottom edges, and it's rounded on the crown. So in other words, it looks very similar to that of a pillow. Right, so it's very pillow-like. If you take a look at your pillow, how soft it is on the top and how slightly curved it is on the sides, that's what a cushion cut looks like. So if you are into a square cut and round cuts, if those two cuts were to get married and produce children, that's what a cushion cut basically is. And it's also a brilliant cut, so it maximizes the spark of the fire and the brilliance as well. So if you are into brilliant cuts and if you are into a pillow-like shape, then definitely check out our cushion cuts from the traditional line of Fab Moissanite. Now, the fifth cut is a beautiful, beautiful pear. A pear cut, just think of it as a teardrop, right? So all that means is that it's rounded on the top, like that of a round, but as soon as it goes around the edges, it will meet at a fine point at the bottom, okay? So it looks like a teardrop. It is actually a very beautiful cut, and it's absolutely gorgeous because it actually encompasses both shapes, a rounded shape as well as a sharp edge shape, right? So it has sharp corners, but at the same time, rounded top. So if you are into that teardrop look, many people do wear it with earrings. They place it on pendants. Many people love to wear it on rings, but it can go with all types of jewelry. So definitely check out the pear cut, especially if you're looking for some pear earrings or pear pendants. That's a beautiful traditional cut as well. And on top of that, it is also a brilliant cut, which maximizes the sparkle and fire and brilliance of the gemstone. Now the sixth cut is called the radiant cut. What is a radiant cut? So I've just mentioned to you earlier what an emerald cut is. It's basically the same shape, just a different type of sparkle. Okay, so it's an elongated, squarish, sharp edges type of cut, just like that of an emerald cut, but the difference is that it's not a step cut, it's a brilliant cut. A brilliant cut maximizes the sparkle of a gemstone. So if you do not like the classic look of an emerald cut and you prefer a very sparkly look like that of a round brilliant, but you like the shape of an emerald, then basically if you were to marry a brilliant cut with the emerald, then that makes the radiant cut, and it's a gorgeous stone as well. Now the princess cut is actually a gorgeous name and a gorgeous stone in itself, and that's our next cut. That is it's a square cut basically, but a brilliant cut in a square shape. So it has four corners, right? It's even sides, right? And it's a brilliant cut. So it maximizes the sparkle, the look, the feel, the fire, and the brilliance of the cut. And it's also a very gorgeous, gorgeous type of gemstone. Now, the next gemstone is called the marquee. What is a marquee, right? So many people don't know what a marquee is. It's actually a very, it was a very popular look back in the 90s, but it's making a comeback these days. People just love it. If you are into a very classic touch, it even has a more of a vintage feel to it. It's just actually a really stunning look and feel. It's pointy on the top, and it's also pointy in the bottom, but it's just rounded on the sides. So if you think about it, it's almost as if an oval and a pear gemstone got married and made babies. That's what a marquee-shaped type of gemstone looks like, okay? So it's a really unique cut. It almost looks as if it's a, if you turn it to the side, it can be someone's eyes, right? So it has a very unique look, touch, and feel. It just depends on how you visually can see it. But that's just a gorgeous, gorgeous cut. And it's also a brilliant cut. And as you can see, I've already mentioned, out of all the cuts, most of them are brilliant cuts because people love that sparkle. So the marquee shape is also a brilliant cut. Now, the second to last cut is called the Asher cut. Now, if you loved the emerald cut and you love the step cut in the emerald cut, but you don't like the elongated look, then guess what? You can go for the Asher, because all an Asher is a square emerald. Yes, it's even-sided, okay? It's a step cut and it's not elongated. So if you love that classic look, if you love the reflecting mirrors of the step cut, if you love what that entails, then definitely check out the Asher cut. And the last cut of the traditional Fab Moissanite line is the heart shape. That's self-explanatory. It's a beautiful rounded on the top and it meets at a corner at the end. Okay, so it's a heart-shaped, brilliant cut Moissanite. It's for all the heart lovers out there, and there are many of you, and that is also part of our traditional cut. Okay, so that's the first collection, which is the traditional cut. So the second line of Fab Moissanite is called the First Crush, all right? So what is the First Crush? Well, basically, there is a line of Moissanite called Crushed Ice. And what is Crushed Ice? Well, unlike that of the traditional cuts, Crushed Ice, if you think about it, if you take a look at a glass and crush and fill it with a bunch of crushed ice and look through the glass, that's essentially what a crushed ice Moissanite or gemstone should look like. When you look through the gemstone, the way it is cut and faceted and polished, it should reflect a specific type of design, a specific type of light reflection, a specific type of visual and imagery within the gemstone, where it looks as if it's a bunch of crushed ice. And it's very unique and absolutely stunning, okay? And many people love it. So within the crushed ice look, what shapes do we have here at Fire and Brilliance? We have many, many different shapes. It goes from the cushion. We also have an oval. We also have a skinny oval, and we also have a radiant, pear, elongated cushion, as well as skinny elongated cushion. So you may ask, what does that mean to have a cushion or a skinny cushion? What does that mean to have an oval or a skinny oval? The only difference is that the skinny ovals, the width of the gemstone is smaller than that of the length to give it a very slender look. Whereas if you prefer to have a wider look, then the width is going to be a little more symmetrical to that of the length of the gemstone. Okay, so many people prefer the skinny look, but many people don't. So we have both. And again, what does that mean? So all of the different symmetry and beautiful alignment of the gemstone in terms of the shapes and how it's cut is similar to that of the traditional cuts that I just mentioned earlier. The only difference is that in this specific line, it's specifically called Crush Ice. Our line is called First Crush, and our Crush Ice line has the gorgeous imagery, the gorgeous reflection to make the gemstone look as if it is crushed ice, as if you were to put crushed ice in a glass. Okay, so that said, that's a gorgeous thing about crushed ice, and many people purchase crushed ice to put on their engagement rings, to wear it on their earrings, to wear on their pendants, to wear on their bracelets, and at the same time, some people are just collectors. They just like to have the loose stone, believe it or not. So if you're one of those, definitely reach out. Now, that said, our next collection is called the Cupid Collection. And if you can't guess it, it's the Hearts and Arrows collection. Okay, so that's a beautiful Cupid collection. We have two shapes in the Hearts and Arrows or Cupid collection. Number one, we have a round shape. And number two, we have a cushion shape. So you may ask, what's the difference between a round and a cushion traditional versus a round and a cushion Hearts and Arrows, right? Where they're both brilliant cuts, that's the same thing. They both are trying to maximize the sparkle of the gemstone. But the difference between a Hearts and Arrows versus that of a traditional cut is that if you take a look from the top down into the crown of a gemstone, and you take a look at the way the faceting is placed, then the light reflection should look as if there are arrows pointing out, okay? For both the round and the cushion. And if you were to take a look at the pavilion facing up into the gemstone under very specific lighting environments and in a loop, then you can find the shape of hearts. And that's the reason why it's called the Hearts and Arrows, because it requires a specific type of precision cutting in order to get those shapes to actually reflect in light, when light is actually shining through it, okay? So if you do not see arrows when looking into the crown of the gemstone through a loop under specific lighting environments, and at the same time, if you look through a loop under specific lighting environments into the pavilion, if you do not see hearts, then that is not a Hearts and Arrows. So we have precision cutting Hearts and Arrows by master cutters from all across the world, and we have that in both a round and cushioned shape. Now the next line is called the heirloom. All right, so the heirloom is a vintage cut. Why is this so interesting? Because we wanted to bring back the cuts of yesteryear, right? So we wanted to bring back all of the gorgeous cuts of the kings and queens. And during that time, there are round shapes and there are cushion shapes, but they did not cut it as a brilliant cut. Rather, the faceting were larger. The culet, or the tip at the bottom of the gemstone, was actually faceted or cut off, and it gave it a very unique look. So many jewelry gemstones from many years ago in the medieval times and even before that, the faceting technique without the current modern technology was much larger. The facets were larger, the culet was cut, and therefore it's more of a vintage cut, which falls into our heirloom collection. So number one, the round cut in our heirloom collection is actually called an OEC, or an old European cut, where you can see that the crown is higher, the pavilion is slightly short, and the culet is actually faceted, and all of the facets are large. So if you take a look at the crown, looking down into it, you should be able to see a flat open space where the culet was faceted. The same goes for the OMC, or the old mine cut. Now, that an old mine cut is almost the same as an OEC, or an old European cut. The only difference is that the OEC is a round cut, whereas the old mine cut is a cushion cut. Okay, but both of the faceting techniques are very similar: large facets, faceted culet, and a higher crown. Okay, now the OMC can also be cut as an elongated version of a cushion. So if you are not interested in an OMC that it has even sides, then we also have an elongated OMC with longer sides, so that you can have an elongated OMC. And we also have a rose cut. What is a rose cut? A rose cut is actually quite beautiful. It looks as if there's just a huge crown and a flat surface without a pavilion. That is a rose cut. So all it looks is, it looks as if it's a dome, if you will, and it's faceted all the way around on the dome, but at the bottom, the pavilion isn't there. It's just faceted all the way through, and it's just completely flat. So that's actually called a rose cut. And the last cut in our heirloom collection is called the even-sided Asher cut, okay? So, or octagonal cut, right? So all of the sides, all eight sides are all the same, okay? So all the sides are measured the same, and therefore there are even-sided or octagonal cut, but it's an Asher cut or a step cut that is a square emerald step cut. All right. So when we first introduced our line of moissanite, we did not have colored fab moissanite just yet, because during that time, the technology wasn't there to actually make very specific permanent colors. And we did not want to introduce any type of colors that were not permanent, right? Because over time, many times when you wear jewelry, and it has been coated, then over time the color may fade away. And that's something that we did not want to do. Now, as of last year, or maybe about 8 months ago, we have introduced colored Fab Moissanite into our line. The permanent colors that we have are yellow, blue, black, brown, green, and as of now, we do have a teal color to make it look as if it's our own color. So if you checked out our Fire and Brilliance design and color scheme, it's almost as if it's a slightly teal bluish color, right? So we have a gemstone that is a teal color, a specific gemstone, moissanite specifically, that is teal in color, and yes, that is permanent. Okay, so if you're interested in colored gemstones, if you're into a permanent gemstone, a permanent solution where it will not fade over time, we now have it. We have colored Fab Moissanite that we have added to our lines, and obviously they're all available in most of the traditional cuts, from rounds, ovals, pears, radiance, emeralds, what have you. Okay, so, and last but not least, the one thing that I do want to emphasize again is that since we do work with many master cutters around the globe, domestically and internationally, we can also custom cut Fab Moissanite. So you may ask, what does that mean? Well, all that means is that if you find a shape that you like that we do not provide, or if you have a specific shape that you want to cut that no one has cut before, then all you have to do is reach out, and one of our jewelry consultants will be more than happy to assist you in finding a gemstone that you like, a shape that you like, and we will hire one of our master cutters to custom cut that shape for you, that size for you. If whether you want a brilliant cut or a step cut, it's just really up to you. What is it that you like? We can custom cut your gemstone. As long as the master cutters can do it, we can make it happen for you. Okay, so that said, I did want to end with the custom cuts, because many people don't know that we custom cut gemstones all the time. It's something that we do on a daily basis. If there's a gemstone that you want us to custom cut to your liking, regardless if it's a type of cut, regardless if it's a type, if it's a specific shape, regardless if it's a specific color, regardless if it's a specific size, regardless if it's a specific type of a brilliant cut or a step cut, definitely let us know. We can custom cut it for you. So the way I want to end it is to let you know that here at Fire and Brilliance, our Fab Moissanite lines, the five Fab Moissanite lines, is the traditional cut, the first crush or crush ice cut, the hearts and arrows or the cupid cut, the heirloom or the vintage cut, and now the colored gemstones or the Fab colored gemstones, and the custom cuts, all included, are all made of high quality, cut by master cutters around the globe, made with high quality, and at the same time, we spend a lot of attention to detail to ensure that you are satisfied and so that the gemstone can stand the test of time. All right, guys, so I hope you guys really enjoyed what you saw there. Again, this is by popular request from our fans, our followers. They want a refresher. They want to know what's the difference between our brand and other companies. They want to know what's the difference between our Moissanite line and other companies. They want to know what's the difference between what we can provide versus other companies. And this episode is dedicated to you, for everyone that has been seeking this information directly from us. Okay, so that said, I hope you really enjoyed it and you really can take a look at our lines on our website at Fire and Brilliance.com, and you can check out all of the lines for yourself, from the traditional cuts to the heirloom cuts to the crush ice or the first crush to the hearts and arrows or the cupid. And we also again introduced the colored Fab Moissanite line. So if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. And that said, thanks again for tuning in. Subscribe to the channel, shows us that you support us. We're also on TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, as well as Twitter. And I'll see you again next time. Goodbye.